reactor kind of solves most of my lazy reefer issues when it comes to media reactors, which is largely just having to pull them out, usually pump and all, just to swap out the media. Which means I tend to put it off and not do it when I'm supposed to, which is hard to admit, but I do have my shortcomings, and I am willing to admit that they exist and try to work around them. This, on the other hand, is the Torq G2 from Nyos. It consists of a dock and a body. First you get the dock, and then you can put any of the three bodies on top of it. And I love this design because it means I can leave that dock in my sump, pop on a body, let it go until the media is expired, and have a second body waiting with fresh media, and swap the old with the new one so that my tank gets fresh media instantly, while I can leave the cleanup of that old media and body for another day when it's more convenient and I actually feel like doing it. In other words, I get to be lazy and my tank doesn't have to suffer that reality. There's more going on here as well that I can also appreciate, so let's dive right into it. The Nyos Torq bodies come in three sizes, the 0.75, the 1.0, and the 2.0, able to hold up to, you guessed it, 0.75, 1 and 2 liters of media respectively. And like I was mentioning earlier, all three are compatible with the Torq dock, which has a max flow rate of approximately 264 gallons per hour. How it works is pretty simple. Fill the reactor body with the appropriate amount of your favorite media, then place the reactor body onto the dock and adjust the flow to match the requirements of the media by twisting the reactor further to increase the flow. There are indicator markings that line up with the arrow on the dock to help you visualize where you are between the max and minimum flow. Once the media has expired and it's time to swap it out, twist it and slide it off, dump it out, give it a rinse and repeat. It is very straightforward and quite brilliant, really. Beyond the basics, they do include some other nifty features. For example, rather than sponges to divide and contain the media, Nyos has opted for mesh screens instead, which are not just going to be easier to clean and last for as long as you own the reactor, but it should also bog down less frequently than sponges tend to do, requiring less maintenance less often. On the 1.0 and 2.0 bodies, you actually get a divider that'll allow you to use two types of media simultaneously, which can be very convenient, provided that both medias require the same flow rate. And they also made it easy enough to fill both sides. First, fill the side with the divider, pop on the cover, flip it around, remove the opposite cover, and fill that side. But like I was saying at the beginning of the video, it's the lazy reefer in me that really loves this design because it allows me to do maintenance on my reactors in a way that works best for me. Having multiple bodies, swapping them when it's convenient, and cleaning up those used bodies when it's convenient without having to remove pumps and fuss around with cords and tubing is so much better. And when it does eventually come time to give everything a proper deep clean, both the reactor bodies and the base come apart completely so you can easily clean them up of algae and biofilm to keep them running like new. If, like me, you just find typical reactors a bit cumbersome and inconvenient to work with and you'd like to try something that will take things to the next level so you can be lazy efficiently, you could check out the Nyos G2 Torq reactors right here.